three finals down, two to go then. Our women's singles final between Sabrina Jaquet and Mette Poulsen, the sixth and third seed respectively in this all-seeded European affair in women's singles. Sabrina Jaquet there on the left of your picture, ranked 63rd in the world. Mette Poulsen from Denmark, the third seed, 43rd in the world. Just 20 world ranking spots between them. Sabrina Jaquet is the sixth seed. She's looking to add a first Scottish Open title to a Swiss international tournament victory earlier this year. She reached the final, taking out Mia Blichfield in a very long semi-final, a 64-minute marathon, saving a match point in the second game and two more match points in the third. It's been a great week for this player. She represented Switzerland at the Rio Olympics and was in the same group as the lady we saw earlier, Scotland's Kirsty Gilmore, an ambassador this week. She's been a big addition to the tournament, Kirsty, even though she's not been active on court. 29 years old, she's been as high as 37th in the world. That was back in June of last year. Jaquet. She's come through the top half of the draw. She's played 20 events since losing first round here last year. Won the Swiss International, I said. Five quarterfinal showings as well. And, well, most recently, a Bitburger quarterfinals as well. Her opponent today, the Danish 23-year-old, 6 years her junior. Ranked 20 spots higher off a career high, the lefty. So the favourite for this one, really, but they have met twice before, these two. And, well, Jaquet winning in 2012 and in a European Club Championships, and Poulsen winning earlier this year at the Orleans International. So deadlock on the head-to-head, one match apiece. So it could go the distance, could well do, but this Danish-Swiss clash. What will unfold here? Gail, your thoughts on this one?
Well, I know that Sabrina Jaquet is the older player, and I remember her when I was playing. So, you know, I know that she's got a great pedigree in being in situations like that, like this. But she's had some very, very tough, well, to be fair, both girls have had some very, very tough matches to get here. Mette Poulsen, she's, you know, one of the new Danish girls that are coming through the system. Again, she's got great, well, big boots to fill with the likes of Camilla Martin and Tina Rasmussen. And Denmark are desperately looking for the next Camilla Martin, the next Tina Rasmussen. And she fits a lot of those, she ticks a lot of those boxes. She's a tall girl, she's left-handed. Tina Rasmussen had that great height and great power. So I really think they're putting a lot into Mette Poulsen to try and see if she can step up and achieve what those two girls did. She hasn't quite managed to do that yet, but again, it's opportunities like this, the final of the Scottish Open, for her to say, hang on a sec, I can do this. She's just seen her compatriot earlier in the men's singles win, so Anders Antonsen went and won the title in the men's singles. So for her, she'll want to show that the women can do it as well.
Yeah, she'll be looking to take the title back to Denmark following Lena Kirschfeld's victory last year against Scotland's Kirsty Gilmore. Kirsty said that she just couldn't do anything against her. She was just too good. Our umpire and service judge on screen. Say hello to them. So, Sabrina Jaquet just waiting for her opponent to lace up her shoes.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Mette Poulsen, Denmark. And on my left, Sabrina Jaquet, Switzerland. Mette Poulsen to serve, love all, play. Service over. One, love. Service over. One, two.
So the compression sock scale, is that something that we see a lot of?
We see this more and more. I don't think they were invented when I was playing, but they do, whether they help a lot, but if it is just a small percentage here or there, it can, and psychologically, it probably mean a lot more to the player if they're wearing them. It does, because of the nature of badminton, you're the agility, the movement, the aerobic and anaerobic side of it, it does take its toll, and you're playing these matches over and over again, consecutive days. There's no break in play like there are in other sports. So you do feel by the end of the day, your calves are tight, and you might not have physio or massage facilities available at the tournament. So these socks, and you see them on the arms and shoulders, the thighs, they do help a little bit just to ease that pressure. And once you get warmer, it keeps the heat in with the muscles, and that just makes you it feels easier to move around the court.
And assuming she flew here, do you think she'll be wearing them on the plane?
Well, we were told any long-haul flight, you wear the compression socks and all the way up. Some of us always, wore the full set leggings even. You have to think about... It's not a holiday. You're not going there to lie on a beach, or you're not going there to sightsee. You're going to play a sport, so you need your body to be in the best condition when you get there. So it means hydrating all the time. It means making sure you don't have anything, any chance of any swelling in your calves and ankles.
Four, three.
We also saw a little bit of pink tape up the nape of her neck. That's just indicating that she's got a little tension around the upper back.
I bet you won't be able to find a player who isn't wearing any tape, because badminton is not an easy sport. It is aggressive on the body. It might not be the most aggressive with the shuttle and hurt the most or whatever. It takes its toll. You're playing in every trajectory. That means your muscles and your body are twisting and turning all the time. And I say, this is consecutive days. It will take its toll.
Service over. 5-0.
Nervous leave there from Poulsen. Didn't get a read on that return from Jaquet at all.
No, and whether she didn't want to go around the head, with that bending of the back, and whether that is something to do with the tape as well, could be a factor.
Having just watched a lot of doubles today as well, watching the singles unfold now, it's just so physically grueling, isn't it? In and out of the corners, there's a lot of ground to cover at speed.
Right shot from Jaquet. Mette Poulsen is a tall girl, so for her, if you can cut that shuttle down steeply, that's going to be the most awkward shot for her. She's got a long way to go down to get that. She's not the most agile. She's got great reach and great power, but the agility is going to be her weakness.
Absolutely right. Clever ploy from Sabrina Jaquet there, just trying to get the shuttle down low. Another player of that tall sort of stature. Sun Yu from China, 6 foot odd, and vulnerable to those low shots as well. And, of course, tying her up in the body with those long limbs.
Seven. 6.
Well, Sabrina Jaquet has got to go for the line. She's got to go for those corners because of the reach of Mette Poulsen, she's got to make sure that she hits the right spot because otherwise she's going to get caught out. But already Athena just make those mistakes. They're going into the tram lines, and this is not good enough. It's better to keep those shuttles in court than it is to try and go too close to the line and then hit it out.
7-9.
Another service foul here, deemed too high. It's got to be lower than the last rib, I think.
Now, speaking to someone over lunch at that, one of the umpires I was sat beside them, they were saying the racket head has to be dipped down noticeably so, some sort of angle from the elbow or from the wrist, you know. Sometimes they contact a little too high.
Yeah, and the shuttle, but I don't understand how you can tell where the last rib is. Waist, and it's very subjective.
Nine-all.
Great shot for Sabrina Jaquet here. Twisting and turning Mette Poulsen. Mette Poulsen expecting a drop shot. Couldn't move that, turn that those shoulders around quick enough.
Service over. 10-9.
Just wrestling for the ascendancy into the mid-game interval, these two at the moment. Just gives you a little bit more breathing room if you can go in there in the lead.
Service over. 11-10, interval.
Poulsen it is then, with the 1 point advantage. It's a very close women's singles final so far in this opener.
Neither girl has really stamped their mark on this game. It's been very tense, it's been very nervy. Both have made mistakes, there have been a couple of winners, but there's nothing really to say, wow, this person really wants it, or this person's really going to play their A game. Whether it is the nerves, the occasion, maybe they just trying to get used to the conditions, whatever it is, it's going to be possibly a game of working each other out. And it's hard because it's not the great spectacle that we want. We know these two girls can produce some great badminton, but we have to respect that this is the way sometimes at badminton or any sport can be played, when the nerves and adrenaline and everything's coming is right on in the arena. I'm hoping that it starts upping the pace and we see the real quality that these girls can produce.
12-10.
They're familiar foes as well, aren't they? Having played twice before in match badminton, so you'd think they'd be aware and gemmed up on what's to come. Poulsen with the 2 point advantage now, third seed. wonderful finish. And she'll be gunning for a top 50 spot by the end of the year, you'd imagine. Currently ranked 63rd, been inside the top 40 about a year or so ago. Knows what it takes, just got to execute the plan.
Sabrina has been one of those players that's been playing the circuit for a long, long time now. And so I remember when she was, you know, just sort of graduating from the junior badminton to the senior ranks. So she's really, really worked hard. And she's in her late 20s now, and she's still struggling around that, you know, sort of 40, 50 ranking. For her now, it's whether she can step it up and break that. Because it's about what. She's a good player.
14, but 12.
Is she good enough to make the top 30, the top 20, break it into there? And what I call, so the big leagues are making a real impact out in the Far East, where a lot of the top players will be playing their badminton. It's unfortunate because she's a great fighter. She's a great competitor. She really wants it. You can see that on her face. But whether she's got the skill to be able to execute what she wants to do all the time is another factor. So for me, it's these mistakes that she just hits now and again. They're too early on in the rally. She should be setting herself up more, getting back into position more. And she probably doesn't need me to tell her this. She probably knows this. And that just adds to frustration.
And again, 50, another 12. Shuffle misses by the odd millimetre. And it is consistency at this stage for Jaquet. Spilling too many errors.
Service over. 13, 15.
Just when you thought Sabrina Jaquet was flickering into form and retaining some consistency, 16, she nets another and allows Mette Poulsen to keep the two-point advantage. Sabrina's coach. Familiar failings, though, for the Swiss at the moment. Just missing on odd occasions. It could prove costly.
Great reach from Mette Poulsen. She just stuck her arm up in a racket and was able to get that drop shot in. She was not moving her feet particularly well, but she didn't have to. Just guided that shot over the net.
She's got that Danish swagger as well, hasn't she? It seems whenever they play in Europe, they just own it, don't they? Antonsen earlier, ripping the mic away from you as if to say, give it to me, let me tell you how good I am. She's similar.
Again, it's that culture, isn't it? It's when you see your teammates win, it gives you that buzz as well. It really does.
It's infectious.
Service over. 15, 18. set. Play your leg.
Really good awareness from Mette Poulsen here. She uses the momentum of the shot, that drive into the forehand corner. It just allows her to step up that court, anticipate the drop shot, and then she can come in and kill that shuttle.
It's been a really sort of staccato performance from both, hasn't it? Very in and out, and it's been kind of rhythmless this opening game.
I just think both girls are tired.
Mm.
I do. I
tired or tight?
Both.
Mm.
Both.
Determined point from the third seed. Grit etched all over her face. She just did not want to concede this, having given so much.
20 game point 18.
It was a tired movement still. She's holding her leg there. I'm not sure she's playing with her compression socks, but for me, those attempts at a dive were laboured. You know, it was the shoulders that dropped first. In badminton, you've got to move your feet first. If you move your upper body first, you're out of position. You're not in control of your movement. And she dropped her body as she went down. And then it was like a real struggle to get back up. And fair play to her, she did it. But it was that mental toughness that allowed her body to move around. And this is where I'm just not convinced by her quite just yet. It doesn't seem like she's really flowing.
And disturbingly, she was bent double there for quite a while, feeling her left knee. Let's hope she's okay. She's got a couple of game points here to consolidate and lock in a game advantage.
Game.
She does indeed wrench the opening game. 21-18, Mette Poulsen leads in this women's singles final. Half of the way home for the Dane.
Kim Nielsen, the Danish coach, will be happy, but I don't think he'll be very happy. He'll be happy that she's got a game on the board. He's smiling at her. I'm probably thinking, well done, you scraped that, because it wasn't pretty. I like the fact that, you know, world-class players or in any sport, the ones that can win, even when it doesn't look good, they're the ones that really can sort of climb up those world rankings and make a difference. And she did that. She hung in there. Whether she can carry on like that for another set or two, if Jaquet gets her game together, if she gets her consistency going, it's going to be a lot of hard work, and she'll have to dig deeper. Jaquet was doing, you know, some good things, but again, that consistency wasn't there.
Yeah, the Swiss player definitely has to tidy up, no doubt about it. And if she does, you feel Poulsen might be slightly vulnerable. There might be a physical issue here. I was wondering whether, as the coach came on, Kim Nielsen, it was a bit of an anxious smile.
Yeah, it was more a smiling through gritted teeth. Are you okay? Yeah, all is good, all is good. You'll be fine. But it wasn't convincing, was it? And that, for me, sums up Mette Poulsen's performance today. It's not been convincing. I know she can play a lot better than this. But you know what? She just has to do what she has to do. And if it's enough, it's enough.
Yeah, absolutely. It's not a perfect world. It's just getting through on perhaps feeling a subpar day. Here she is then, a game to the good. Start of the second game here, Poulsen to serve.
One love.
And that is what Mette Poulsen is very, very good at. And that is an incredible shot. There are not many girls in the world that will be able to get that shuffle back. It's at the limit of that on the line. And she drops her racket. She goes for her overhead. She drops her racket down. So the racket goes behind her back. So it's very hard to see what angle she's going to produce at the last minute. So it's clever, but it can cause a few inconsistencies.
Well,
Sabrina Jaquet got away with this shot. It's not the best shot here. It's a cross-court lift. It's short. Mette Poulsen just didn't get her feet in position.
Mette Poulsen has a lot of power and range on those long levers, and conversely, Jaquet prides herself normally, you would imagine, on consistency. But today, she's just missing too many shots too often. And almost imposing pressure on herself.
May have got. She couldn't see, but I do think that shuttle landed out. But again, the umpire couldn't see because Mette Poulsen was in the way. So you're just going to have to accept that her body obscured the view.
She rights a wrong in her mind. She felt hard done by, but she's come out on top. I was curious how she was going to react after that incident.
Five, three.
Jaquet showing a lot of character there, digging really deep and moving well. She has to be super agile because she doesn't have the natural raw power and ability to hit 3 points the Mette Poulsen
four,
does.
Five.
Yeah, she was very clever in that rally. She was she kept luring Mette Poulsen over to her forehand side, and Mette Poulsen didn't know where she was going to. Jaquet's got a very good slice, cross slice drop into the backhand corner of Mette Poulsen. So by pinning her in that forehand corner, Poulsen was trying to say, is she going to cross it? Is she going to cross it? Is she going to cross it? And then she did it very well, played that straight. And then when she took a chance to attack, she did it perfectly.
5-0.
You do get the sense that the demeanour and body language of Mette Poulsen, if this goes long, she looks like she could tire and wilt quite relatively easily compared to Sabrina Jaquet, who looks a little bit more sprightly. But for Sabrina, it's all about keeping the shuttle in more often.
Yeah, normally I wouldn't say that. Mette Poulsen's a great athlete. I don't feel it quite yet from her. Whether she's going to get into the game a bit more and then she suddenly starts flowing, that movement's a bit better. But for now, she looks like she's desperate to win in two sets.
Wonderful spike down the line here.
And the reason why she can do that shot, she gets that left leg into position. She takes that big lunge. All that weight is then centre, and that gives her that chance, better chance to hit that shot perfectly. Jaquet is still choosing to pin Mette Poulsen in that forehand side, and she really needs to change her tactic now.
Just sort of allowing for the drift. We've seen that a few times now, haven't we? Was she just spilling over the back line, and it seems to take her a little while to get it up together. I don't know what it is. She's just a little subpar.
I don't know. It's hard because I don't know her as a person, but it is frustrating when you are watching a game of badminton and someone keeps hitting it long. For her, she knows not to hit it so hard when you're on this side because she's on the faster end.
Stop!
But it's everything sometimes goes blank in your mind when you're in the final. The cameras, the lights, the crowd. It just adds pressure, and sometimes your brain just doesn't quite work all the time.
Well, the young Dane, the third seed, is 23 years old, containing her opponent well so far.
Better from Jaquet. She's not doing the high shots because she's been missing on them. So she's attacking that shuttle, bringing that down. And she's just questioning Poulsen.
Service over. 11-8, interval.
A three-point advantage then for Mette Poulsen. Third seed in a strong position now. Closing in, you feel.
Next summer, Badminton Scotland are hosting the best players on the planet, and you can be here to see
well,
them.
Well, this second set is turning out to be just like the first. There's no rhythm. Both girls are making mistakes. No one's really putting their stamp on this game. And at the moment, Mette Poulsen's just been allowed to have a few more chances to hit the smashes down the line, more than Sabrina Jaquet. But Sabrina Jaquet, at the end of that first half, has, you know, shown that she, if she does attack, she can twist and turn Poulsen around the court, and that's what she's got to do. She's got to just go full out there and do that, not to give Poulsen time to be able to create the angles.
Tight, straight net shot there. Still, you get that sort of sense that neither are that convincing at the moment. It's not lived up to its billing, this women's singles final, has to be said.
Tired body here. When you're moving into the net area, you need to be in control, and it gets that upper body collapsing with it when she hits that shot, and it drags the shuttle down into the net.
She's insistent that it landed out. Lines judge suggests no, and the umpire stands by.
In second time, it's wrong.
No.
Please. Tosses the shuttle away in disgust.
Oh, I can't call that.
11-8.
Very close.
Sorry, 11-12. Play.
We don't have the benefit of the challenge system here, the Grand Prix level.
Leg.
Better from Jaquet. She's moving Poulsen around the court much better. Poulsen's getting to touch. She's not getting that body in position. Her legs aren't moving quickly. Her feet are moving.
There's a real energy about the Swiss right now. She's picking it up physically. By the horns and just trying to haul herself through and extend this match as long as she can.
Well, she'll be so confident by watching Poulsen's movement. When a game is slow, it's amazing how it can drag your movement down as well. And I think Poulsen, if the game speeds up, she might have a chance to get herself back into it. Fantastic pickup with Jaquet. That was incredible. Poulsen really thought she had a winner there, but Jaquet just got enough racket to it.
Service over.
That's a shame because it was a mesmerizing 30, turnaround in 40. This game from the Swiss player. Get the sense that if this does go to three games, that Jaquet just looks slightly more sprightly.
Definitely, she's still moving around the court quickly. She's her body language, yeah. As Poulsen, everything seems an effort. She's holding Mette Poulsen's really feeling that left knee. So I don't know if, not sure if it's because it's bruised at all from the diving, but something's not quite right.
Did she get called to the umpire because of intimidation issues with the Lions
judge?
It's
so hard because, you know, this is where I like seeing character on court. I like seeing personality. But It's very hard to where the line is between celebrating that the opponent has
missed,
intimidating a line judge, and, you know, the just general etiquette. I think that for me, you should trust the line judges not to be swayed. This is what you have to do. The tournament referees and the umpires and service judges, they know not to be swayed, so trust them.
Good close there. Pounced on that one. Took the shuttle very
16,
high.
15.
There's a bit more variety of Mette Poulsen's shot there. She dragged that shuttle down steeply into the mid-court and then just gave her that chance to step in and attack the next shot.
Thank you.
can tell that we're at the sharp end of this match now. That was a really tightly contested point from both. Deadlock in the second game. There's no calling this second game. It's very tight.
No? What do you want? Yes.
It's okay. Oh, come on.
Please, play. Please.
Well, the rule is when you change the shuttle, it's down to the server. And if an opponent says, can we change the shuttle? And the server says no, then it goes to the referee. It goes to the umpire. And the umpire then can say yes or no. It's just to stop changing the shuttle as a tactic. And otherwise, it just gets silly. But I still don't know if both players agree and the umpire says no. I'm still confused. It's a great rally again. Mette Poulsen finding that line on that tram line so well.
Just wait.
Yeah, that's been the standout feature of her game, hasn't it? That spike down the line. She does that really well off the forehand side. Deadly accurate with it.
Sorry.
You do get the sense that she's kind of clutching at this left knee a little, and you think that, well, she has to get this done in two games, really.
Yeah, and she's got, from diving, she's now got some blood. The doctor has to come on. The trouble is he can't put a plaster on it because the players are sweating so much and they just get plasters everywhere. And you can't put any bandage around because you need to bend the knee and it's always at the joints, you know, the elbows and the knees. So, they're going for a plaster. That's not going to last very long. Good luck. I'll give that a point. Oh, no, we're going for more.
That might secure it for a couple more points.
But as soon as you bend your knee, that's gonna fall off. I thought Poulsen was in control of that rally. She did that great cross-court smash and she opened the court up, has Jaquet moving, and then simple arrows. It's that floaty shot on her forehand that she's really struggling with.
Slice drop from Jaquet, that just dropped like a stone 19, when it cleared the net. 17.
but she knows that's her best shot. For me, that's, well, for me, that's Serena's best shot. So I have wondered why she's pushing Poulsen so much in her forehand, but she is dragging Poulsen further and further into that forehand, and that gives her more time to do that slice. But I'd like to use it a bit more. I'd like to see her open that court up. She's not using absolutely every area. If you're playing against someone like Poulsen, move her corner, 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 corner all the time.
Delight there as that went wide from the Swiss player and brought up three consecutive game points. Going the distance in the women's singles final. Sabrina Jaquet, fully animated. She changes ends.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's well, Jaquet should be very, very proud of herself there. I think that, you know, on paper, she's the lower ranked player. On paper, she should be the one that's, you know, she'd be down and out of this match, and there were chances that Poulsen had to make sure that she won that in two games, but she stuck in there. I was still concerned about her tactic to keep on that forehand side of Poulsen, but when she did that cross-court drop shot, it worked really well. Now, the third set is going to be interesting because she stick with that tactic of staying down that forehand and then using that slice. But for me, if I was in her position, I'd be like, right, you know what? I'm still feeling good. My opponent's not looking good moving around that court. I am going to move the hell out of her. Let's move her corner, corner, here, 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 and toy with her. Because Poulsen, her mind is questioning her body. She's going for a left knee a lot. The compression stops. It doesn't scream out, you know what? I'm really raring to go right now. So for me, you know, she's just going to go for it, just move her around. Poulsen, let's just, for me, attack. Every single thing, attack. Every point, just unleash everything. This is, if she wants this title, we'll see how much she wants this title, that's for sure.
It's going to come down to a test of will and strength of character right now. Who wants it more? It's been a scrappy affair throughout. Very little between them.
Test
of will. Sabrina Jaquet to get us underway in the decider.
Service over. One. Love.
Well, if that's maybe an indication of Mette Poulsen's desire, really screaming at herself. She was hitting her thigh.
Like she's rattled at the fact that she lost that second game, letting it slip from her grasp. She was up throughout most of it.
Oh.
But in fairness to Poulsen, now the third seed, she executed your game plan, Gail, just going lights out at everything and trying to take Sabrina Jacquet's time and space away.
She has. Yeah, she has. And that rally, I was thinking she was doing everything that I thought she would, and she was crossing and opening up the court. But again, the longer the rally keeps going, you can see her willing or wanting that shuttle to land out. And instead of still working.
That's how she wants her points. Short and decisive. She wants them out of the point fairly quickly either way.
Service over. 2-4.
You do all that work and then service fault. She got service faulted before for a flick serve, so she didn't adapt. Brilliant net play, and Jaquet is so well there not to really cause some damage or land into the umpire's chair. Such tight net shots here, and she gave it a great go of trying to get it back and then nearly ended up in the box.
Favourite pattern of play, isn't it? That slice drop she uses so effectively. Okay. And again, just as you sense Poulsen's trying to break away, she's denied much of a lead.
Well, Poulsen got the first one, which was Jaquet went up and she used her body. It was a high forehand, and it was the clip cross court that she didn't read at all. So Poulsen, to credit to her, that she could read that slice drop, but it was the clip that's got her, so she's got to be aware, she's still got to keep moving, and her knees are getting more and more bloodied by these diving across the court.
Keeping the shuttle in play, being more consistent now, something that in the opening game she wasn't. Really turned it around well, Jaquet.
Service over.
Angry roar from Poulsen there.
4.
No, will not be denied. Shouldn't really have lost the second game, in all honesty. turning up the power. That's what she wanted.
Audacious shots from Jaquet, that lovely backhand, and I wasn't sure she was going to make that shot, but she was very unlucky. Again, good pressing from Poulsen. Lovely round the shuttle shot on that backhand, overhead backhand from Jaquet, but she missed, she hit it in the tram lines, much to the delight of Poulsen.
Job manoeuvring Poulsen around a lot in that point. It's a grueling point to lose. Seems to pain more when you come the wrong side of this one.
Again, it's that upper body that collapsed into the shot. She got her leg there, but it was that shoulder, the left shoulder just dropped. She didn't have that stability. With that left knee is causing her some problems. When you do those big lunges, when you're tired, there's a slight niggle there or a slight worry, you're not confident, that causes the upper body to collapse. Poulsen's looking more and more dejected. She's looking at her coach a lot more. She's really asking questions herself.
But then suddenly she gets these angry phases, doesn't she, when she goes on a tear of, say, 2 or 3, 4 points. But she's certainly struggling now. Jaquet recovering the deficit well. She's best at her best, Poulsen, when she's slapping her thigh and throwing herself around with full conviction.
Poulsen's a better badminton player when the pace is high. She reacts to the shuttle. She's not very proactive. And when the pace is high, she's in her element. Jaquet can play at any pace. She scraps every shuttle. She's, like I say, she's not the most consistent person, but she's a fighter. Poulsen, the slower the rallies are, the loopier the shuttles, it gives her that thinking time. And she's not liking that. She's not liking the fact she has to think. She's got to think about her movement, think about her knee, whatever's going through her head, it's not happening.
Service over.
10, 9. That's a great anticipation net kill there from Poulsen. She took a chance. Jaquet did so well to stay in that rally. Those net shots were right from the floor.
Heads to the mid-game interval, still with her nose marginally in front, just the two-point advantage for Poulsen. It's been a tight contest throughout, real scratchy affair. Neither can break away from the other easily, and if they do, well, the other claws it back.
Well, these girls have been playing for over an hour now. At times, it's not been great badminton. But also, at times it's been grueling, it's been psychological, it's been mental, it's been hard. These girls have played every day since Tuesday, Wednesday. Every match has been tough for them. And you can see that they both really, really want to win, but it's the pace isn't right for Poulsen. She's struggling to cope with the slower shots of Jaquet. And Jaquet is just hanging in there. She knows that she just has to do that. Just twist and turn Poulsen at the right time, and she's in with a shout. If Poulsen can step up a gear, get that attacking game going that she had at the start of this third set, she can get some points on that board and hopefully, cause some mistakes from Jaquet. Poulsen definitely up the pace in that rally. Every shot Jaquet was reaching. Poulsen was in control.
Reverse slice from the top draw, that one.
10-30.
She doesn't really put much slice on this either. She just delicately places that shuttle. It's not much there. So it just goes floatier. Most people would expect, the reverse slice and that speed, but she's being very clever again. Mette Poulsen wants the pace of that shuttle, taking that off and just softly hitting that shuttle over the net cross court. Very, very clever indeed.
It's like Mette Poulsen is just trying to sort of stall for time between points as much as she can so that she can then just unleash the fury of a high intense point when she actually gets to do it. But she is stalling for time quite a lot, and it's frustrating Jaquet at times. Still has the 2-point lead though, the lady in blue.
That's a great shot, great backhand. 11. She's wanting to wipe her face again, and the umpire's letting her, so... Jaquet's not happy about this at all, but, you know, it's the umpire's discretion. Poulsen asks, the umpire could say no. Really behind Jaquet because they can see that she's just
40.
Staying in that rally. She's putting every shot she can, just making Poulsen move around that court. And it was that deep forehand shot again on the forehand side. Poulsen couldn't get that left leg lunge out behind the shuttle. It was very, very late, very labored movement, and she collapsed that body.
Play.
There's no conviction on her shot.
And inevitably, the body goes through these sort of like lulls in energy from time to time throughout any tournament. And you've just got to ride it and hope that you feel better shortly, sort of thing, if it is a bit of an energy lapse. But she's on the rebound nicely here, Poulsen, with the upper hand again.
From Jaquet for a long, long time, and that's a simple straight drop shot. She's usually missed by hitting out in the tram lines or at the back, but this is the first time she's hit it in the net for a while. Whether she's feeling that pressure. Well, she's pointing to the area where she dropped down, but there is no sweat on that court now.
No, she didn't hit the deck.
No.
And I don't think she's sweating that profusely, so it's just to gain a little bit of time, breathing space. Keep the scoreboard pressure on Jaquet. That's her thoughts right now.
Poulsen went for this round the head shot, but as you can see from her body, it was so late that she hit that shuttle late. She dragged it down with her arm. It just shows how tired she is.
And as she's done so often throughout the entirety of this match, every now and then, when she needs it most, she can get a quick point through the power of the smash and accuracy.
The crowd are really feeling Jaquet's pain here. That's a simple error. She did not have to go so close to the line on that shot, and she hit that charm line very badly.
Well, just for a while there, she looks convincing, but then still work to do. Two more points required for the third seed here to get across the line and walk off with the title.
Service over.
Well, that backhand net error from Sabrina Jaquet yields 6 match points for Mette Poulsen. That's what it means to her. What a reaction. Got across the line after a testing afternoon for Mette Poulsen. Sabrina Jaquet frustrated but denied. The Danish third seed here does what Lena Kirschfeld did last year. Walk off with the title. 21-18, 17-21, 21-14 in 75 minutes played. Not the most convincing performance from Poulsen, but she'll be delighted to have come through. Sabrina Jaquet was frustrated by the stalling of Poulsen and the tactics in that regard. She played a good match herself, couldn't quite turn it around. It was a very spirited middle game that she snatched her way and took us to a decider, but not denied at the final hurdle. Let's hear from our winner.
Mette, I think I can safely say from everyone here watching that match, we were glad we were watching it and not playing that. That was tough.
Yeah, it was really tough. I was struggling a lot in the second after I was leading. But I had the whole time the focus to that it should be very hard and keep the discipline, and that was actually a lot of the tactic today, that it's impossible to win this match without it. It's a very tough rally, so I had to keep it in touch and stay focused.
Your celebration at the end, it just showed how much this title means to you.
Yeah, it means everything. It's my greatest moment of my career so far, so I'm really, really happy and satisfied.
And just a final word on your opponent, Sabrina. She gave everything on that court.
Yeah, I actually thought that I had it in second, and then after leading 12-9, I was 12-14 behind, and a lot of frustrating, but I really hang into myself, and I think that it's the reason why I came out as the winner.
Well, you certainly are the winner. You are the Scottish Open Grand Prix 2016 Ladies Singles Champion. Take a bow. Let's hear it for Mette Poulsen.
everyone, it's now time for the presentations for the women's singles final. Please welcome the players into the arena.
Mette Poulsen then, it's a good finish to her year. A couple of runner-up showings earlier in the year, the Dutch International denied, the Prague Open denied as well. But this time, having been sick of being the bridesmaid, she actually wins the title. Comes through on what was a difficult day for her physically, slightly a niggle in the left knee, seemingly clutching at it quite a lot throughout, but got there in the end. And that's the mark of a true pro, when you can win when the chips are down and you're not feeling at your best.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our presentation party. Mr. Paul Jeffson, Managing Director of Yonex UK. Mr. Dan Travers, President of Badminton Scotland. And Judy Murray. Congratulations to our finalists, and thank you very much to our distinguished guests for taking part in the presentations. Your last chance to light up the Emirates Arena.